Here comes Justin's off-road truck. Playing in the mud today. He's not the only one that can play in the mud. See, I'm not the only one that can have a large drink in the cup holder. Look at this little fat ass over here. Say hi, Justin.
Hey, everybody.
Look, this is what you call a promotion. He's got him a name tag now.
Oh, yeah.
A name tag and a lunch pail. Look, he's got his phone over there, a walkie-talkie. Boy, he's almost going incorporated.
We are.
Got that damn inch of dirt on the floor mat. Yeah, priorities are not about the floor. It's about moving dirt with my teaspoon. Quarter yard at a time. That might be a half. A massive scoop right there. If you dump some more on the back of the engine compartment, it'll hold more.
Oh, yeah. As long as it leaves the hole.
That's right. It's going to be quite the deep pond right here. It looks like it's going to be about 10 feet deep right here. Watch the flawless movements of this professional operator right here. Look at that. That is smoothness.
Chris taught me well.
It took him a while, but he finally watched enough videos, he learned how to do it. I don't want to hear nobody say, I need a bigger bucket. I don't want nobody to ever say, I need a bigger bucket again. I believe this is the first time you're ever going to have to wash the Terex when you're done with it.
I think it will be. Get every ounce on it we can.
It's going out in the field. It don't matter if you spill it, does it?
No. As long as it gets out there.
As long as it gets out of the pond.
That's all we're concerned about.
To go. Spin, baby.
for some commentary while I load? Come on, it'll make a good video. I won't throw you off. Now, Justin, you're blocking the camera.
Oh, okay.
You think you can? Can you handle?
Yeah, I can.
Can you handle all this?
Oh, yeah.
I don't want to get out of control with this massive bucket. Everybody ain't gonna let you down over this bucket now. So Justin hopped out of the seat and put it on my pattern because he runs deer pattern. Deer patterns for fat goats.
Well, that's what I've always run.
See, I'm multi-coordinated. I can run both.
Yeah.
But I'm better on the excavator on cat pattern.
Yeah. That's why I swapped.
That's why he swapped it for me. I got in it and I didn't think about it. I went to town. I was like, damn, he done learned cat pattern there. He done swapped it on me and didn't tell me there. I done hopped in here and went about my business like I knew what was going on.
He said he wanted to run it, so I flipped the switch.
I think he's tired of running it.
Oh, yeah.
According to all this, you're going to be running it for a little while longer.
We might be halfway. Might be.
How long have y'all been working on it?
I've been hauling here, just hauling dirt. I've been hauling here a week. And, of course, we took off yesterday for Thanksgiving.
Yeah. Y'all gonna work tomorrow?
I don't know. I'm gonna see what everybody wants to do.
See how froggy they feel.
Yeah. It took me a week to get it cleared. So we've been working here about 2.5 weeks.
Uh-huh. That all the brush that come from here?
Yeah.
That wasn't too terribly bad then.
No, well, I cleared it this summer. It was all this that was sitting on was in trees.
Oh, really?
And then I just left the dam in trees. And then I came back, he said he wanted to do it this fall. When I came back, I just cleared the dam.
Yeah.
But
yeah, y'all like how I placed that one in there?
Oh, yeah.
Get a little height on it there, it fills in the corners.
Oh yeah.
Oh, you ain't gonna dig around and try to put it where it needs to go. Just compile it in there. See, you compiled it all over the engine compartment by there.
I got it on it.